Am I clearly visible, audible? Give me a thumbs up in the chat box if I'm clearly visible, audible fast. Okay, thanks for confirmation. So I welcome you all for this session. A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Priyanka Sajdev here, NEET PG educator on An Academy. And today I'm here to continue my series for FMG. I'm targeting FMG audience here. So I'm giving specific details of the lectures for FMG students who are targeting this December FMG. So I'm short, crisp, according to the topics. So today I'm here to continue with pathology. In pathology, we have already covered general pathology. Here I'm starting with hematopathology. So in hematology, there are three chapters we know, RBC, WBC, platelets. So today I'm here to teach anemias. So today in 1 hour, anemia will not be complete, but today half of the anemias will be complete. And tomorrow, the next lecture tomorrow, we will complete all anemias. After that, one lecture on leukemias and lymphomas and one on platelets. So the 4 lectures, we are going to complete entire hematology. Yes. So I'm starting with hematology without wasting time. I will be a little bit faster. Huh? If you have any doubt, please write it. Your doubt in the chat box first. Then as soon as I will notice it, I will address it. Done. It is not necessary at the same moment I notice your doubt and address it. So please don't mind it. Write your doubt in the chat box. I will notice it. I will address it as soon as I finish the topic. So I'm starting with hematology. In hematology, we have to deal with RBC, WBC, platelet, the three disorders, erythrocyte, leukocyte, and thrombocytes. So I'm starting with RBCs today. Before starting that, you should know important points about hematopoiesis. Hemato means blood. Poiesis means formation. So formation of blood takes place in the bone marrow. So the process is known as hematopoiesis. We know, you can see, just a second. You can see all the cells are formulated from a cell in the bone marrow, which is known as hematopoietic stem cell. So you can see hematopoietic stem cell is the father of all cells. So all cells are derived from one cell, which is known as hematopoietic stem cell. Is there some marker which is for hematopoietic stem cell? Yes, CD34. Learn for MCQ purpose. So CD34 is the marker for hematopoietic stem cell. You can see CD34. It is a marker for stem cell. Stem cell ka ISC marker is CD34. You can see only stem cells are becoming brown color, taking the stain. No other cells are becoming brown color in the bone marrow. So again, a very important MCQ, CD34. Name the organs in which hematopoiesis takes place. So when we were embryo inside the uterus of the mother, this is the embryo inside the uterus of the mother. So hematopoiesis from 2nd week to 10th week of gestation. 10th week means 2.5 months. Till 0 to 2.5 months, total 9 month gestation. Hematopoiesis takes place in the yolk sac. So yolk sac is the first organ in which hematopoiesis takes place. So hematopoiesis takes place in the yolk sac of the embryo. You know, there is a yolk sac. Inside the yolk sac, hematopoiesis takes place. After 10th week to 24th week, means 8 months of gestation, it takes place in liver. So liver is the second organ. And after that, it always takes place in the bone marrow. In adult life, it takes place in specific bones. So name the bones in which hematopoiesis takes place. It is skull, it is sternum ahead, vertebra behind. So it is skull, sabse upar skull hai, sternum hai, vertebra hai, connecting the sternum and vertebra are the ribs hai, uske alawa pelvis, humerus and femur. So these are the bones you can see here, which are marked by red color. So these are the bones in which hematopoiesis takes place. So what is the sequence, you tell me? What is the sequence? It is yolk sac, followed by liver, followed by bone marrow of the large bones. So this is the sequence. So till 10 weeks here, till 24 weeks, and 24 weeks onwards, it takes place in the bone marrows. Everyone give me, yeah. Along with liver, spleen is also there. Who's asking? Dr. Tariq. Yes, along with liver, spleen is also there. You can see liver and spleen, but mainly it is in liver. And spleen also, there is a small fraction you can see, Dr. Tariq. Done. So that is the thing. Okay, I would like to tell you some more details here. Okay, how many types of blood cells we have? We have 3 types of blood cells. We have RBCs, okay. There is no further types of RBCs. There is platelets. There is no further types of platelets. But WBCs are of 2 types. WBCs are of 2 types, granulocytes and agranulocytes. The granulocytes again are of 3 types, which have granules in their cytoplasm, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil. So neutrophil have pink colored granule or purple granules in the cytoplasm. Eosinophil have red colored granules in the cytoplasm. Basophils have dark blue or black colored granules in the cytoplasm. Agranulocytes do not have granules in the cytoplasm. That's why known as agranulocytes. So lymphocytes and monocytes. So total 5 types of WBCs are there. So see, there are 5 types of WBCs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One is RBC, one is platelet. Total 7 cells have to be synthesized from one cell known as hematopoietic stem cell. So this hematopoietic stem cells form 2 cells, 2 stem cells, myeloid stem cell and lymphoid stem cell. Lymphoid stem cells forms only lymphocytes. Rest of the cells, that is all RBCs are formed from myeloid, all platelets are formed from myeloid, and except lymphocyte, all other WBCs are also formed. That is all granulocytes and agranulocyte with a monocyte. They are also formed from myeloid. So myeloid series is known as trilineage. Trilineage series, because all three series are formed from myeloid. RBCs also, all RBCs. Platelet also, all platelet. And from WBC except lymphocyte, all WBCs are also formed from myeloid. So hematopoietic stem cells, me say, can you see in the diagram also, this hematopoietic stem cell giving rise to two stem cells. This is myeloid stem cell, it is known as trilineage stem cell, and it is lymphoid stem cell. Lymphoid stem cell means if lymphoid cells are formed, lymphocytes are formed, B and T lymphocytes. And myeloid means all RBCs are formed, all platelets are formed, and except lymphocyte remaining all four WBCs, that is neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil and monocytes are formed. Give me a thumbs up. This is the summary of hematopoiesis. I am done with hematopoiesis. So you can see hematopoietic stem cell, two stem cells, myeloid and lymphoid. Lymphoid is forming only lymphocytes, only lymphocyte. Myeloid is forming RBCs, platelets and except lymphocytes, all WBCs. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I'm starting with anemia. Before starting anemia, important points about RBCs on which questions can ask. I'm giving you only those points on which MCQs can be framed because I have to be fast, huh? So erythropoiesis, how RBCs are formed. You will tell me, ma'am, RBCs are formed from myeloid precursor, but what are the intermediates? So these are the intermediates. You see, this is a hematopoietic stem cell, this is a hematopoietic stem cell, this is a myeloid stem cell. From hematopoietic stem cell, myeloid stem cell is formed. Myeloid, it is not lymphoid, myeloid stem cell. Hematopoietic stem cell, myeloid stem cell, from that three cells are formed: early, intermediate and late normoblast. Early normoblast, intermediate normoblast and late normoblast, and ultimately reticulocyte is formed and RBC is formed. So total, these are the precursors. You can see this is hematopoietic stem cell. From hematopoietic stem cell, early, this is intermediate and this is late. Early, intermediate, late normoblast are formed, then reticulocyte is formed and then RBC is formed. So hematopoietic stem cell se leke RBC ke beech mein, these are the intermediates. Learn other names for the normoblast. Early is known as basophilic normoblast. Intermediate is known as polychromatic normoblast. And late is known as orthochromatic. So how you will learn? BPO is the mnemonic. There is a mnemonic BPO. Early, intermediate, late. BPO. B means basophilic. P means polychromatic. O means orthochromatic. So from hematopoietic stem cell, myeloid stem cell is formed. Then early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast. Then reticulocyte is formed and then RBC is formed. So early is known as BPO, BPO, normoblast, basophilic normoblast, polychromatic normoblast, orthochromatic normoblast. Give me a thumbs up, everyone give me a thumbs up. So you can see in the sequence as we are moving ahead, you can see the size of the RBC going on decreasing. Number one. Do you see the color of the cytoplasm? Here it is basophilic, and as we are moving further, it becomes eosinophilic pink color. Why it is becoming eosinophilic? Because the cytoplasm contains hemoglobin. So hemoglobinization first time takes place at intermediate. Can you see? See the color change. First time color change takes place here. Cytoplasm ka color change. So first time cytoplasm ka color change takes place at intermediate. So hemoglobinization takes place at intermediate normoblast. Again, a very important MCQ. One more thing, you can see the nucleus in the cell. Nucleus is there. Nucleus is extruded out and there is no nucleus there in the reticulocyte and RBC. So at late normoblast state, nucleus is extruded out. So two MCQs in this. Number one, hemoglobinization kaunsi step pe hota hai? Answer is intermediate normoblast. Number two, nucleus ka extrudation kaunsi stage pe hota hai? Answer is late normoblast. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So two questions, two answers based on this series. What are the two questions? Hemoglobinization kaunsi step pe hota hai? Is step pe. Nucleus ka extrudation kaunsi step pe hota hai? Is step pe. So this is intermediate normoblast. This is late normoblast. These are the other names of intermediate and late. You already know. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I know I'm fast, but I have to be. Should I proceed? Now, regarding the morphology of the RBC, we know the diameter of all RBC is 7.5 micrometer. Please learn it. It is 7.5 micrometer and in the center, one third, there is no hemoglobin. There is no nucleus in the RBC. This peripheral is red in color, red due to the presence of hemoglobin in the periphery, in the cytoplasm. So hemoglobin is present at the periphery in the cytoplasm, providing pink or red color to the RBC. The central one-third is empty. It doesn't contain hemoglobin, so it is pale. It is not red, it is pale. This is normal RBC. It is normal. So see the size, see the color. Size, color. Size is 7.5 and color is peripheral two-third is red. Central one-third is white or pale in color. You know the reason. This is normal. So central one-third is pellar. You know the lifespan of RBC, it is 120 days. Now there are, depending on size, there are three things. Depending on color, there are two things. So based on size, compare the size of RBC with lymphocytes. See, there are three slides in front of you. In all of them, you can see one lymphocyte, one lymphocyte, one lymphocyte. Please see, we compare the size of RBC with lymphocytes. So these are the lymphocytes. Now compare here, the size of the RBCs with this lymphocyte. Lymphocyte is also 7.5 micrometer. So they are same as that of lymphocyte. We can see it is normocytes. Normocytes means size is normal. Here I can see the RBCs are little bit smaller as compared to lymphocytes. That's why known as microcytes. And here RBCs are larger than lymphocytes. That's why known as macro. So normo, micro and macro. Side. Side. The term here is side. You know, side means size. So sides, normocytes, microcytes and macrocytes. So we are comparing the size of RBC with lymphocyte and seeing whether it is same size, smaller size or larger size. Normocyte, microcyte, macrocyte, that is variation in size. So variation in size is three types. And in all three, we are comparing RBC with the lymphocyte. Again, important MCQ. Coming on color. On color, we have only two things. Now see, normally central one-third is pellar. Central, see all these RBCs. Can you see all these RBCs? In all these RBCs, see the central one-third. This central one-third, central one-third, central one-third is pellar and outer two-third is red. Outer two-third is red. Compare here color. Here pellar is more and colored region is less. So here pellar is more than one-third. So when pellar is more than one-third, it is known as hypochromia. The word chroma means color. You know chroma, the dictionary meaning of chroma is color. So it is hypo, color is less now. Color is less, pellar is more and peripheral color, red color is less because hemoglobin is less. So it is hypochromia and it is normochromia. Normochromia, normochromic RBCs. So normochromic and hypo, there is never hyper. Color zyada kabhi nahi hoga, kam hi hoga. So there are two things. Based on size, RBCs are of three types. Based on color, RBCs are of two types. Based on size, it is cytic. It is cytic. It is cytic. So it is normocytic means same size. Microcytic means small size and macrocytic means large size. Size is compared with lymphocyte. So here we are comparing all the sizes with a small lymphocyte. It is normal, small and large. And color, if we say color, color is chroma. So it is chromia, chromia. So chromia is only two, hypo and normo. It is normochromia, normochromic and hypochromic. Normo and hypo, there is never hyper. So there are five things, normocytic, microcytic, macrocytic, hypochromic, normochromic. Give me a thumbs up. So the word is chromia means color and cytic means size. Everyone give me a thumbs up. These are the basics you should know. So based on this, I will classify anemia, morphological classification of anemia. Listen, everyone. The first type, normocytic, normochromic. So NN, normocytic, normochromic. This is the first type. The second type, microcytic, hypochromic. So here normo norma means size is also normal, color is also normal, but patient is anemic. The RBCs are of normal size, normal color, but patient is anemic. So such anemia is known as normo normo, normochromic, normocytic. Second type of anemia, the RBCs are small in size, that is they are microcytic and they are having less color, hypochromic, microcytic, hypochromic anemia. The second type, the third type is important. The third type, the size is larger, macrocytic. But color is not hyper. Hyper to hota hi nahi hai na. So macro ke saath normo hi jayega. So macro with normo. Have you got it? So what are the three types of anemia? So if you say from cytic, if you say from chromic, cytic and chromic. You know cytic means size, chromic means color. So it is normocytic, normochromic. It is microcytic, it is hypochromic, microcytic and hypochromic. It is macrocytic. Macro ke sath wapas born ho aayega. So the three types of anemia are in front of you. I cannot simplify more than this. That is beyond limits. You know, I went beyond limits to simplify it for you guys, I guess. You should thankful for to me for this. Yes. So normocytic, normochromic, the first type of anemia in which the size of the RBC is normal and color is also normal, but patient is anemic. Here the size of RBC is small. Size of RBC is small and color is also less at the periphery. Central color is more. So it is known as microcytic and hypochromic anemia. The third type is macrocytic and normochromic. The size of RBC is large, but they are normal in color. So macrocytic, normochromic. So have you got the three types of anemia? Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I want thumbs up from everyone. If I'm asking, yes, IDA will come on the classification. Don't worry. ACD, IDA will come on. They're all of them step by step. First, understand the basics. Those who don't know the basics, they should know these basics before understanding the anemia. What is normal? Even students can't say the classification. They just confuse normocytic, hypochromic, AAO. So normal with normal. Normocytic, normochromic, done. Microcytic, hypochromic. So both are less. Here both are normal. Here both are less. Size is also less. Color is also less. In the third, color size is more, but color is normal. Color can never be more. Color can never be more. It is normal. So it is macrocytic, normochromic. Does you have any confusion? I guess you shouldn't. So yeah, that was the thing. Two more terms for you before leading to anemia. Two more terms. Anisocytosis, poikilocytosis. Anisocytosis means size. All RBCs are of various size. Some are small, some are large, some are normal. So some are small, medium, large. Variation in size is known as N. Isocytosis. Iso means same or N means not. So all the size are not same. Cytic means size. So split it, na? N means no. Iso means similarity, equal. And cytosis means size. So no equal size. So N isocytosis. So that is the term. Done. And poikilocytosis means variation in shape. So some RBCs are circular, some are elliptical, some are spherical, some are tear shaped. So variation in shape is known as poikilocytosis. So in this diagram, you can see an isocytosis. I can find small RBCs also, normal also, large also. So that is an isocytosis. Done. And here I can see poikilocytosis. I can see various shapes. I can see spherocytes, microspherocyte, elliptocyte, ovalocyte, keratocyte, stomatocyte, sickle shape, so target shape. These are the various shapes. So just poikilocytes. Let me start anemias now. The basic is over. Let me start anemias. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So what is the definition of anemia? We all know reduction in total RBC. But it is difficult to measure RBC. That's why we measure hemoglobin, because each RBC contains hemoglobin. So reduction in hemoglobin is anemia. But actually, this is not the definition of anemia. If you see from Robbins, the definition of anemia is this: reduction in RBC mass. But it is difficult to measure RBC now. What is the normal total RBC count in an adult human being? It is 4.5 to 5.5 million. These are the, so counting RBC is difficult. Each RBC contains hemoglobin. Counting of RBC, counting RBC, counting of hemoglobin, measuring hemoglobin is easy. So if there is reduction in hemoglobin, that is known as anemia. That is a secondary measure of anemia. The primary measure is RBC. Okay, if you got it, I should move ahead. Okay. So what is the normal hemoglobin range? What is the normal? For males, it is 13. It is the lower limit. It is the lower limit. 13 gram per deciliter. Hemoglobin is measured in grams. Huh? It is not milligrams. Please clarify your basics. For females, it is 11.5 grams. And for newborns, it is 15 grams. Now, there is a person. I'm saying, please mind my question to all of you. Please mind my question. There is a person having hemoglobin 12 gram per deciliter. Now my question, whether the person is anemic, yes or no? Say your answer as yes or no. Whether the person is anemic, yes or no? The hemoglobin of that person is 12 gram per deciliter. Who will tell me the answer? Say yes or no. Say yes or no, right? Y or N? Yes or no? Manu, why no? Sunil, why yes? Shrini, why yes? Khushi, why no? You all are wrong. You cannot say yes or no. You should ask me what is the sex, what is the gender of the person. If I'm saying only person, you can't say whether at hemoglobin 12, he or she will be anemic or not. I have not told you whether he is a male or she is a female. Yes, Vamsi, you are right. You should ask me. You cannot tell the answer till that. You say, ma'am, there is no answer. First, tell me the gender of the person. First, tell me the sex of the person. So if I'm saying he's a male. So for male, minimum hemoglobin should be 13. So he's anemic. Yes, anemic. If it is a male, he's anemic. But if it is a female, male hai to anemic hai. If it is a female, she's a female. Female mein minimum is 11.5. It is more than 11.5. So she is not anemic. So 12 hemoglobin for males, it is anemic. For females, it is normal. So it is a lower cutoff you should know. Have you got it? So this type of questions can be framed. Have you got it? So you should know the basics. And if it is a newborn, of course, it is anemic. For newborn, the cutoff is 15. If it is a newborn, it is anemic. For it is a male, it is anemic. If female, it is not anemic. So that is the answer. Have you got it? Coming on classification of anemias. We can classify anemias by two ways. Morphological and etiological. Morphological, I have already told you there are three classes. Microcytic, hypochromic, both are less. Size is also less, color is also less. Normocytic, normochromic, both are normal. Size is also normal, color is also normal. The first is size, the second is color. So first is size, then color. First size, then cytic, then chromic. Pericytic and chromic. The third is macrocytic. Size is more, but color is normal. So macrocytic, normochromic, because color is never more. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up. So the three slides are in front of you. See the first slide. No, see this slide. This one I'm marking. So can you see a lymphocyte in this slide? All slides should contain a lymphocyte so that you can compare the size of the RBC. For comparing, you require a lymphocyte. In this slide, see all the size of the RBC is same as that of lymphocyte. And see the color. The central one-third is pellar. So it is normocytic, normochromic. Done. This is the first. Coming on this one. Here, compare the size of the RBCs with this lymphocyte. Compare the size. So RBCs are a little bit smaller in size. So it is microcytic and color is also less. Color is only at the periphery. The central one-third is more pellar. So it is microcytic, hypochromic. And see the third type. Where is the third type? Let me show the third type to you people. This is the third type. Now compare the size of the RBC here with that of lymphocyte. The RBCs are bigger in size. So they are macrocytic, but central pellar is still one-third. So it's macrocytic, normochromic. Have you got it? Now, which anemias are which? Some of you were saying the ICD, ACD. So what it is? I will tell you mnemonics. So if any person is coming to you complaining, doctor, I'm having fatigue, I'm having weakness. So you do a CBC. In the CBC, you found hemoglobin is less. All anemias, hemoglobin is less. So hemoglobin is less for that particular sex and particular age. So if it is a newborn, it is a male, it is a female, depending on that, hemoglobin is less for that category. So patient is anemic. Yes or no? First thing you should see is MCV and MCH. MCV indicate the size of RBCs. MCH indicates the color, that is cytic and chromic. So first decide, your first approach after looking at the hemoglobin should be that the anemia is microcytic or macrocytic or normocytic. Which type of anemia is it? Which type? So I will tell you mnemonics. So if it is a microcytic anemia, you have only four options. The mnemonic is SITA, S-I-T-A, SITA. Sideroblastic anemia, iron deficiency anemia, I-D-A. Thalassemia, P. And anemia of chronic disease known as ACD. Anemia of chronic disease is known as ACD. So sideroblastic anemia, iron deficiency anemia, I-D-A. Thalassemia and ACD, S-I-T-A, SITA. SITA is microcytic. Learn like that. SITA is microcytic. You know the full form. Coming on macrocytic, there are four options. Again, only four options. The mnemonic is Lady Harding Medical College, LHMC. L means liver disease, cirrhosis, alcoholic, liver disease. H is hypothyroidism. Hypothyroidism leads to macrocytic anemia. M is megaloblastic anemia. Megaloblastic anemia due to two reasons, either due to folic acid deficiency or vitamin B12 deficiency. And C, cytotoxic drugs, especially methotrexate and phenytoin. So LMSC, Lady Harding Medical College. Coming on normocytic, if the anemia is normocytic, you have two options. See the reticulocyte count. Reticulocyte count is high or reticulocyte count is low. If reticulocyte count is high, it is hemolytic anemia. One of the hemolytic anemia. So mnemonic is SHARP. You have five options. SHARP, S-H-A-P-E. S stands for sickle cell anemia. S for hereditary spherocytosis. A for autoimmune hemolytic anemia. P for PNH, paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria. And E for enzyme deficiency, G6PD deficiency. So you know all of them are hemolytic anemias. Write down hemolytic anemia here. So you will remember they have high retic count. And low retic count, you have three options. Four options. R stands for renal failure. A for ACD, anemia of chronic disease, dono jagah aayega. M for myelofibrosis and Chandraka C is for cancers. So that is the thing. So first, if patient is anemic, having hemoglobin low, you have to see MCB and MCH. So you have to see whether the anemia is microcytic or anemia is macrocytic or anemia is normocytic. If it is microcytic, you have four options. Sita, you know the full form of Sita. It is sideroblastic anemia, anemia of chronic disease, ACD, IDA, anemia, iron deficiency anemia, and thalassemia. You know the full form of Sita. If it is macrocytic, there are four options. Lady Harding Medical College, you know the full form of it. It is liver disease, hypothyroidism, megaloblastic anemia due to B12 and folic acid deficiency, and cytotoxic drugs, phenytoin and methotrexate. Give me a thumbs up. If it is normocytic, look for retic count. If retic count is more, it is hemolytic anemia. Write down. If retic count is less, you have to learn the name. So what are the names? Retic count is more, it is shape, S-H-A-P-E, shape. And if retic count is less, it is Ramchandra, R-A-M-C. So it is renal disease, anemia of chronic disease, it is myelofibrosis and cancers. And you know the full form of shape also, na? All hemolytic anemias are there. Shape mein kuch nahi hai, hemolytic anemias hai. So it is sickle cell anemia, it is hereditary spherocytosis, it is autoimmune hemolytic anemia, it is PNH, paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria, and enzyme deficiencies with G6PD deficiency. I cannot simplify more than this slide. Please include this slide in your high-yielding notes. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone. Many of your MCQs can be cracked from this slide. Everyone give me a thumbs up fast. I need thumbs up fast. Should I proceed ahead? Okay, done. So that is the classification of anemia. So we have classified anemias morphologically, then coming on etiological classification. Morphologically, we have seen microcytic, macrocytic, normocytic, or kaun sa anemia kis mein aata hai, we have seen. Coming on pathophysiological or etiological classification. Etiological, what is the etiology? Now, there can be three reasons. Now, listen, again, I have simplified, super simplified for you people. Please write it down. Anemia can be due to three causes. Either there is blood loss. Just suppose there is a person, I am the person, I am having an accident. So, having blood loss, so I will be anemic. So blood loss can be one of the reason. Decreased production in the bone marrow. In the bone marrow, production hi kam ho raha hai. Or increased destruction in the spleen. Destruction zyada ho raha hai. So yahan to production kam ho raha hai, ya destruction zyada ho raha hai, ya acute loss. Blood loss. These are the three reasons for anemia. Everyone give me a thumbs up. We will talk about them one by one. Let's take the first reason. Blood loss. It is of two types, acute and chronic. Acute, as I have told you, road traffic accident. If there is a road traffic accident, if there is a surgery, there is acute loss. In surgery, we always give blood as a replacement. Now, so acute blood loss is there. So patient can be anemic after that. Done. And chronic, daily small amount of blood is lost. Just suppose patient is having piles, hemorrhoids, or patient is having peptic ulcer, or patient is having hemoptysis, patient is having hematuria. Blood loss by any route, vaginal route, any route. Blood loss, small amount of blood loss daily. Menstruation, it is a chronic blood loss. So that these are the chronic blood loss daily. So blood loss can be acute, can be chronic. So I'm not going to teach you blood loss, you already know. Coming on second thing, decreased production. Why production should be less? As I told you, production takes place in bone marrow. What were the intermediates? The first cell was hematopoietic stem cell, then myeloid stem cell, then early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast, then reticulocyte, then RBC. Yes or no? In all of these cells, there is cytoplasm and there is a nucleus inside it. Cytoplasm and nucleus. As I have told you, cytoplasm contains hemoglobin. So cytoplasm contains hemoglobin and nucleus contains DNA. Nucleus, of course, contains DNA, common sense. So decreased production may be, there may be defect either in cytoplasm or in nucleus. So that production is less. So production kyun kam hai? Bone marrow mein why production is less? Why? There can be cytoplasmic defect. By cytoplasmic defect, I mean hemoglobin defect. Because cytoplasm contains hemoglobin. Nuclear defect means DNA defect. DNA cannot be synthesized. Or stem cell production, there is a problem with hematopoietic stem cell. Hematopoietic stem cell is absent. So banega kaise? Hematopoietic stem cell hi nahi hai, to banega kaise? Done. So there can be three problems in production. Hemoglobin defect hai. So hemoglobin is made up of two things na. Hemoglobin defect hai, to heme defect hai ki globin defect hai? Heme hai ki globin hai? Agar heme defect hai, to it is IDA, iron deficiency anemia, because hemoglobin is made up of, heme is made up of iron. Sideroblastic anemia or anemia of chronic disease. In tino mein there is a problem with heme. Globin mein defect hai, to there is problem with thalassemia. Again, globin mein there are two chains, alpha chain and beta chain. तो अल्फा चेन का ग्लोबिन में प्रॉब्लम है तो अल्फा थैलेसीमिया, बीटा चेन के ग्लोबिन में प्रॉब्लम है तो बीटा थैलेसीमिया. गिव मी अ थम्स अप. दीज ऑल आर साइटोप्लाज्मिक डिफेक्ट. देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम विद हीमोग्लोबिन. हीमोग्लोबिन में आइदर हीम और ग्लोबिन, आइदर हीम और ग्लोबिन. प्लीज गिव मी अ थम्स अप. आई एम ट्राइंग टू सुपर सिंपलीफाई फॉर यू पीपल. देन देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम विद न्यूक्लियस. न्यूक्लियस इज मेड अप ऑफ डीएनए. फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ डीएनए वी रिक्वायर फोर थिंग्स, एडेनाइन, गुआनिन, साइटोसिन एंड थायमिडिन. फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ थायमिडिन वी रिक्वायर विटामिन बी12 एंड फोलिक एसिड. If there is deficiency of vitamin B12 or folic acid, just suppose in my body I'm not eating vitamin B12, I'm not eating folic acid, so thymidine will not be synthesized. If thymidine is not synthesized, DNA will not be synthesized. If DNA is not synthesized, nucleus will not be synthesized. So there will be a problem with nucleus with the precursor. You should ask me, ma'am, RBC doesn't contain nucleus. So if nucleus mein problem hogi, to hume kya problem hai? Why there should be anemia? RBC mein nucleus nahi hai, lekin uske precursors mein to hai. So there will be the problem in the precursors. Precursors, uske ancestors hi bekar niklenge. So wo jo cell banega, that will be abnormal cell. Have you got it? So there is problem with nucleus. So that is megaloblastic anemia. And problem with the stem cell. Stem cell is absent. The stem cell is absent. So two types of anemia. Aplastic anemia, in which stem cell is absent. So not only RBC, WBC, platelet, nothing will be formed. So patient will present with pancytopenia. Pancytopenia and aplastic anemia. So problem is with the stem cell. Stem cell hi nahi hai. So all the three series are not formed. Neither RBC, nor WBC, nor platelet. Patient will present with pancytopenia. The anemia is known as, this type of anemia is known as aplastic anemia. The problem with the hematopoietic stem cell. Or there is a problem with the precursor only of RBC. WBC and platelet are formed normally. Normal WBC, normal platelet. Only RBCs are not formed. So the precursor of RBC, stem cell which is responsible for the formation of RBC, myeloid stem cell, that is defective. Myeloid may be RBC wala arm is defective. So that is known as PRCA, pure red cell aplasia. PRCA, pure red cell aplasia. Have you got it? So that is the etiological classification. Give me a thumbs up. So I will revise you, help you in revising the classification of anemia. So anemias can be due to three reasons: blood loss, decreased production, and increased destruction. Increased destruction. Give me a thumbs up. Blood loss can be acute, can be chronic. I have given you the examples. Decreased production may, there can be three problems. Either problem with the cytoplasm or problem with the nucleus. Cytoplasm mein problem hai, matlab hemoglobin mein problem hai. Or problem with nucleus. Nucleus mein problem hai, matlab DNA mein problem hai. Or problem with stem cell. Or there is a problem with stem cell. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Hemoglobin mein problem hai, to heme mein hai ki globin mein? Heme mein hai ki globin mein hai? अगर हीम में प्रॉब्लम है तो इट इज आयरन डिफिशियंसी एनीमिया, सिड्रोब्लास्टिक एनीमिया और एनीमिया ऑफ क्रॉनिक डिजीज, एनीमिया ऑफ क्रॉनिक डिजीज एसीडी. ग्लोबिन में प्रॉब्लम है तो इट इज थैलेसीमिया, अल्फा एंड बीटा थैलेसीमिया, अल्फा ग्लोबिन की बीटा ग्लोबिन. गिव मी अ थम्स अप. न्यूक्लियस में प्रॉब्लम है, मतलब डीएनए में प्रॉब्लम है, डीएनए का थायमिडिन कैन नॉट बी सिंथेसाइज बिकॉज देयर इज प्रॉब्लम विद विटामिन बी12 एंड फोलिक एसिड, दैट इज मेगालोब्लास्टिक एनीमिया विल बी अ प्रॉब्लम हियर. एंड स्टेम सेल्स में, ओवरऑल स्टेम सेल में प्रॉब्लम है तो इट इज एप्लास्टिक एनीमिया. Pancytopenia will be the reason, and only red cell wale precursor mein problem hai, that is known as PRCA, pure red cell aplasia. Give me a thumbs up. And if there is increased destruction, it is known as hemolytic anemia. Hemolytic anemia I will teach you separately tomorrow. Give me a thumbs up. I am starting from here. The first anemia today, iron deficiency anemia. I will be a little bit faster. Have you got it? Should I proceed ahead? I am starting the first anemia, iron deficiency anemia. I am starting the first anemia, iron deficiency anemia, which is a microcytic hypochromic anemia. So I'm starting microcytic hypochromic. Sita ka I hai ye. Sita ka I. S-I-T-A. S-I-T-A. Sita ka I hai ye. Give me a thumbs up. So I'm starting with, I know I'm fast, but I have to be. Now I don't have any other option. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So iron deficiency anemia. So these are the headings under which we have to describe it. It is the most common anemia in India. Overall in the world also, in India also, it is the most common anemia. Before coming on the anemia, in short, in 1 minute, I will give you a normal iron metabolism. How normal iron metabolism takes place. I'm eating iron by mouth. So I'm eating spinach, I'm eating red meat, I'm eating jaggery, gur. So whatever iron rich resources I'm having available in my diet, I'm eating. Iron can be present in vegetarian diet also, in non-vegetarian diet also. In non-vegetarian diet, iron absorption is better as compared to vegetarian diet. So this is the iron. Can you see? The person is eating the iron by mouth. It is going in esophagus, it is going in stomach. Whatever iron we eat, it is in ferric form, Fe3 positive. But for absorption, this is the cell of the intestine. Can you see? the iron will be absorbed from here. It will go inside in the blood vessel. This is the blood vessel behind it. So for absorbing, iron should be there in ferrous form. So before that, iron has to be converted from ferric to ferrous form. It is done by HCl present in the stomach, acid present in the stomach. So can you see here in the stomach? Please everyone see in the stomach, ferric iron is getting converted into ferrous by HCl present in the stomach. So more acidity, more conversion, more absorption. So we should eat iron along with acid. Which acid? Citric acid. Citric acid is present in lemon. So spinach. Take a spinach in a bowl, mix lemon in it, mix it and then eat it. So whatever things containing iron, if you take it along with the acid, absorption will be better. Absorption will be better. Yes, it is vitamin C, ascorbic acid. Yes, citric acid, ascorbic acid. Give me a thumbs up. So first thing, okay, ferric got converted into ferrous. So what will happen? This ferrous is coming in the intestine. Can you see this ferrous is coming in the intestine? From intestine, it will be absorbed by the intestinal cell. So this is the intestinal cell. Can you see? This is the intestinal cell. In the intestinal cell, there are two receptors, transporters. This is known as DMT, divalent metallic transporter, divalent. It will take only two positive, Fe2 positive. It will not take Fe3 positive. That's why we have converted it. So Fe2 positive will enter inside the cell and it will present inside the cell. This is Fe2 positive. For entering inside the blood, it requires another transporter. The name of that transporter is ferroportin. Can you see here? This is ferroportin, this one. So iron is coming from mouth. It is going in esophagus. It is going in stomach. In stomach by HCl, it will convert from ferric to ferrous form. Ferrous form is coming in intestine. In intestine, the ferrous form first going inside the cell of the intestine by a transporter known as DMT. Please learn the name. MCQ is there on DMT many times. DMT, the first transporter. But DMT will trap it inside the cell. If it come out of the cell into the blood, it requires another transporter known as ferroportin. Please, it is very important. I'm sorry, ferroportin is there. Ultimately, listen, while passing through ferroportin, again iron will convert from ferric to ferrous. From ferrous to ferric. So hum jo khate hain wo bhi ferric mein hota hai aur ultimately jo blood mein pahunchta hai wo bhi ferric mein hota hai. Only for the process of absorption it get converted into ferrous form. Give me a thumbs up. So ultimately blood mein ab kaun se form mein hai? Ferrous ferric pe there are many MCQs. Please clear your fundals. So ferric form mein hai. In the blood it is ferric form. Ferroportin again transport it and oxidize it into ferric form. So ferric iron is present in blood. In blood, iron travel on its transporter, the vehicle, the car of the iron, in which iron will sit and move here and there. So iron will not move by the foot alone. Iron will sit in the transporter, that is the car. Who's the car of the transporter? It is known as transferrin. Can you see this Y shape? This is the vehicle. This is the transporter of iron. So iron in the blood will sit on the transferrin. Transferrin is the transporter. Transferrin is the transporter of iron. It will transport. It is not iron. It is the vehicle of iron in which iron will sit and move from here and there. So yahan se blood mein se kahan jayega? It will go to the all organs. But mostly iron is required in bone marrow. Because RBC is synthesized in bone marrow and cytoplasm of the RBC contains hemoglobin. Hemoglobin ka heme is made up of iron. So this iron is carried to the bone marrow. You can see this is early normoblast, intermediate normoblast, late normoblast. So which will take iron first time? This is early, intermediate, late. This is reticulocyte and this is RBC. Which will take iron? Which will take iron? Yes, Richard, you are right. I have told you, na? Hemoglobinization first time takes place in intermediate normoblast. That is polychromatic normoblast, BPO. You know the mnemonic, na? So it is the question. Yes, so iron is taken by the intermediate normoblast. Iron is converted into heme. Heme get converted into hemoglobin. All these cells will synthesize the hemoglobin. Extra iron, any extra iron after this, it is carried to the liver. See in the next slide. So any extra iron after this, these are the erythroid precursors. They have taken the iron. Any extra iron is carried to the liver and it will store in the liver in the form of ferritin. Ferritin is the storage form of iron. Ferritin. Now tell me two questions. Which is the transporter of iron? Answer it. And which is the storage form of iron? Answer it. Answer it. So what is the transporter of iron? Who will give me the answer? What is the transporter of iron? Fast. What is the transporter of iron? You all are right. The transporter of iron is transferrin. Very good, Yash. And what is the storage form of iron? What is the storage form of iron in the liver? It is ferritin. It is ferritin. Without any confusion, the concept should be crystal clear to you people. So two MCQs are in front of you. In FMG, they are already asked in the previous paper. So ferritin and transferrin. Storage form and transporter. Learn it. Give me a thumbs up. Fast. Two MCQs. Two important MCQs are in front of you. So that is from the normal this thing. So iron absorption, that is the whole story written in front of you. I'm skipping it. the same diagram from the Robbins, you can see, which I have drawn simplified for you. So you can see here, this is the iron in the stomach. It is getting converted from ferric to ferrous form. Ferrous form is absorbed from DMT. After going inside the cell, it is moving out in the blood by ferroportin. When it comes out again, it gets converted into ferric form. It will sit on the transporter known as transferrin. It is carried to the marrow, bone marrow, and extra is carried to the liver, and liver will synthesize in the form of the ferritin. It will store it. Done. Have you seen it? So I'm skipping the theory. You know it, what it is. One more thing I would like to add here. Hepcidin. What is hepcidin? Hepcidin is a regulator of iron absorption. Regulator. What is hepcidin? Hepcidin is a protein. You know this diagram now. You can understand this diagram well. Now, whenever any extra iron is stored here in liver, I have told you now, in the form of ferritin. Whenever ferritin concentration increases in liver, liver will come to know that iron is extra in the body. We do not need more iron. Iron is already in excess inside me. So liver will synthesize a protein. The name of the protein is hepcidin. Hepcidin is a molecule synthesized by liver. Again, MCQ. So hepcidin is synthesized here. Hepcidin. It is synthesized here in the liver. And this hepcidin, after synthesizing, it is secreted in the blood. It is secreted. This hepcidin via blood, it will go to the ferroportin and inhibit ferroportin. Inhibit. So whatever iron I will eat in diet now, it will go in the stomach. It will go in the intestine. It will be absorbed by DMT inside the cell, but from the cell, it cannot come in the blood because ferroportin is inhibited by hepcidin. So iron will be excreted in the feces. Because it is excess in the body, that's why it is excreted in the feces. And when ferritin is not there, storage form is not there, so liver stops synthesizing hepcidin. So this ferroportin will open up and again absorption will occur. Give me a thumbs up. So that is the thing. Can you see? This is the hepcidin. Can you all see? This is the hepcidin synthesized in the liver. It is going to the ferroportin and inhibiting ferroportin. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Number one function of hepcidin and for mobilizing iron from liver to bone marrow. If I stop eating iron today, from today, I will not eat iron in my diet. I'm on fasting. I'm on malnutrition, whatever reason is it. I'm unable to eat iron. So if I am unable to eat iron, from where my RBC will get iron? You will say my body already have the storage. Now liver will provide the storage. Backup is there in the liver. So ferritin is in the form of storage that will provide for some time, at least for few days, few months. Backup is there in the form of ferritin that will provide iron to the hematopoietic precursors. So again, for transporting iron from liver to bone marrow, we require hepcidin. We require hepcidin. So this is the basis for anemia of chronic disease. In anemia of chronic disease, there is deficiency of hepcidin. Hepcidin will be deficient. So this transport will be inhibited. So the excess of iron is present in the body in the form of ferritin. Still, it cannot be utilized for formation of hemoglobin. So that is the problem with ACD, anemia of chronic disease. Have you got it? Hepcidin is absent. There is hepcidin deficiency. So I will teach you there. You should understand the basics here. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up, everyone. Have you got it? So when iron in the body is low, hepcidin level falls. And when iron in the body is more, hepcidin level increases from the liver. Hepcidin is synthesized from the liver. Can you see? Everyone give me a thumbs up. Last important MCQ, very important MCQ from this slide. This is a 5-star slide. Please add the slide in your high yielding points. Please. The factors which increases absorption of the iron. So is it or factors which decreases absorption? Increases absorption, decreases absorption. Tell me the factors. The factors which increases absorption, it is ferrous form which increases. It is ferric form which decreases. So all acid will cause increase. Name the acid. It can be HCl in the stomach. It can be ascorbic acid, citric acid, ascorbic acid present in lemon, citric fruits. Yes. It can be amino acid. It can be iron deficiency. It can be pregnancy. So these are the factors which are increasing iron absorption. Name the factors which decrease iron absorption. Achlorhydria means decrease HCl. More HCl is increasing absorption. Decrease HCl is decreasing absorption. Alkaline food. Here acidic foods were there. Alkaline foods. Alkaline foods are decreasing absorption. Phytates, tannates, and phosphates. They will form chelates with the iron. Please learn. Phytate, tannate, and phosphate. They will decrease iron. Tetracycline. You know tetracycline is an antibiotic. Again, it will form the chelate. Calcium will form the chelate. So these are the disorders in which iron absorption is decreased. Have you got it? Everyone give me a thumbs up. You already know transported form of iron is transferrin. Storage form of iron is ferritin. And excess of ferritin is known as hemosiderin. So ferritin jab bahut zyada ikhatta ho jayega to use kahenge hum hemosiderin. Excess of ferritin is known as hemosiderin. So pyridine and hemosiderin both are storage form. Give me a thumbs up. So why iron deficiency can occur? Either due to blood loss after surgery, after road traffic accident, or increased requirement. I'm eating normal iron, but you know, in childhood, in growing age, in pregnancy, the requirement is increased. So it is not fulfilling the requirement, or inadequate dietary intake. So patient is not eating properly, or patient is old, patient is not having teeth, or patient is malnourished, or patient is poor, cannot eat. So because of inadequate dietary intake or decreased absorption, patient is eating normally, but absorption is not occurring because patient is having celiac screw, tropical screw, non-tropical screw. So absorption, malabsorption syndrome is there. So either khai kam raha hai diet mein, or kha raha hai, absorption kam ho raha hai, or kha bhi raha hai, absorption bhi ho raha hai, to requirements zyada hai. That is the thing. Or blood loss. Give me a thumbs up. These are the four reasons. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So coming on pathogenesis, what will happen if the person is not eating iron, or if he is eating, absorption is not there? Whatever the scenario, hemoglobin will not fall immediately, because body have backup in the form of ferritin. So first, ferritin will provide iron for hemoglobin for few days or few months. So that is the first stage in which ferritin will decrease, but hemoglobin is normal. So the first stage is depletion of iron storage. Here ferritin will decrease. Ferritin will be utilized for formation of hemoglobin, but hemoglobin is normal. Can you see, patient, if I measure my hemoglobin is normal, but I have stopped eating iron, still my hemoglobin is normal for the next few days, because there is a backup in the body in the form of the ferritin. That ferritin is providing iron for formation of hemoglobin. Have you got it? That is the first stage. Patient is not anemic, patient will not have any symptoms yet. That is the first stage. The second stage, iron deficient erythropoiesis. Now one stage will come. Iron deficient erythropoiesis means now the backup is finished. Ferritin is finished. There is no more backup, no more storage. Now the erythropoiesis will start becoming defective. It will start forming RBCs which have deficient hemoglobin. Because iron is not there, so hemoglobin cannot be synthesized. Still here, hemoglobin start decreasing, but patient will not have any symptoms yet. And the third stage, patient will have dyspnea, fatigue, weakness. That is iron deficiency anemia. So when patient comes to us, we are doctors, they come at stage three, this stage. Before that, these are the two stages which are asymptomatic, but patient is having. So most sensitive indicator for iron deficiency anemia is ferritin. So you don't measure hemoglobin. Hemoglobin to bahut baad mein kam hoga. Sabse pehle ferritin kam hoga. So ferritin is the first indicator which decreases in iron deficiency anemia before hemoglobin falls. So most sensitive and specific indicator for IDA, iron deficiency anemia, is ferritin. Give me a thumbs up. If there is a patient in front of you, you want to do only one investigation for diagnosing iron deficiency anemia, don't do hemoglobin. Do ferritin. If ferritin is less, then hemoglobin can be normal, can be less. If it is normal, it will become less in the next few days. So ferritin is the most sensitive and specific indicator, the first indicator which indicates the patient is having iron deficiency anemia. Give me a thumbs up. Again, a very important MCQ. So based on these, this is IDA. This was all about IDA. Few important points are still there, the treatment and diagnosis. So before that, I would like to run some polls. Are you people ready for the polls? Give me a thumbs up if you people are ready for the polls for IDA. Okay. I will launch the polls if you people are ready, but you have to give me a few seconds. Just a second. Let me see how many questions are there. Five questions are there. You can see the first question is in front of you. Okay. So be fast. This is the first question. You have to be fast enough. You have only 15 seconds. Most important non-specific regulator for iron metabolism. Read the question. It is tricky. Don't rush. I'm asking non-specific regulator of iron absorption. Regulator, but non-specific. So all of you are wrong. All of you. Only three persons are right. Anti, Richard, and Srini. So most of you have marked A as correct answer, but A is not the answer. You have marked hapsidin, because I taught you that regulator of iron is hapsidin. But hapsidin is specific regulator of iron. It regulates only iron absorption, not other absorption. Non-specific regulator of iron is DMT. DMT is divalent metal transporter. So it absorbs all divalent. Fe2 positive, it is copper 2 positive, it is zinc 2 positive. So all 2 positive, it is divalent. That will be absorbed by DMT transporter. So that is non-specific. If instead of non-specific, the question contains specific, answer will be A. But here I have asked non-specific, that's why the answer will be B. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone, those who are wrong, especially those, give me a thumbs up. I want thumbs up, then only I will proceed. This is an expression in front of you. Be fast. Question 10 is accept, don't rush. Iron absorption is decreased by all except. So which of the following increases iron absorption? Which of the following increases iron absorption? Why you people are wrong still? I'm asking accept, accept. So the answer here is ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid increases absorption. Rest all are decreasing absorption. So Dr. Tarek, Shatanib, and Namisha are first to answer it correctly. Calcium form chelates, tetracycline form chelates, phytate form chelates. All of them decreases iron absorption. But ascorbic acid converts ferrous to ferric to ferrous form and increases absorption. So correct answer here is D. Give me a thumbs up those who are wrong. Give me a thumbs up. I want thumbs up from those who are wrong. Give me a thumbs up. Okay. This is the next question in front of you. Okay. Just a second. Do this one. Yeah, which of the following glycoprotein is transported in plasma and iron metabolism? So what I'm asking? I'm asking the transporter of iron. So very easy. All of you are right. Dr. Tarek, Shatanib and Nivedha are first to answer it. The answer here is transferrin because I'm asking the transporter of iron. Instead of transporter, if I ask storage form of iron, your answer will become C. Storage form is C. But here transporter is B. So correct answer here is B and all of you are right, I guess. All of you are right. Okay. So correct answer here is B. This is the next question in front of you. The next question is same, which I have repeated. Storage form of iron. It is repeated many times in your past year papers, PYQs. You can find this question very frequently. So storage form of iron is. So you all are right. 100% of you are right. Very good. The answer is Perkin, Tarek, Samir and Patel are first to answer it correctly. Very good. The correct answer here is A. Ferritin. Very good. Let me move ahead. So clinical features of anemia, we all know it is weakness, fatigue, dyspnea, palpitation, pallor. Specific clinical features. Let me tell you a few specific clinical features on the nails. Patient has spoon-shaped nails. So nails are straight now. This is a finger and this is nail. In these patients with iron deficiency anemia, this is the finger and nail becomes spoon-shaped. Nail become like this. So this is known as, the condition is known as spooning of the nail. Can you see spooning? The condition is known as coelonychia. Coelonychia. Please learn it. It is a specific condition. Coelonychia. Spoon-shaped nails are seen. Number one. Number two, tongue will become atrophic. Can you see? Okay. This is coelonychia. So tongue will become atrophic. This is normal tongue. You can see this is normal tongue. This is atrophic tongue. So tongue will become atrophic. There will be angular. The angles will have somatostatus. The angular somatostatus is there. And in esophagus, babbing is there. It is known as Plummer-Wilson syndrome. You know what is Plummer-Wilson syndrome? There is a triad. Please learn the triad. This PYQ, I have taught you this PYQ when I have discussed PYQs on the last Wednesday. So this was a repeat question. You already know there are many times this PYQ is already there. So you have to learn the triad of Plummer-Wilson syndrome. One of the thing is iron deficiency anemia. The other is dysphagia. Patient can't swallow. And the third thing is esophageal bag. The three things together is known as Plummer-Wilson syndrome. Please learn the triad. One of the thing is iron deficiency anemia. The second thing is esophageal bags. Can you see patient is having iron deficiency anemia, microcytic hypochromic. Apart from it, can you see a bag here? So esophageal bag, and because of which patient is having dysphagia. So this triad is known as Plummer-Wilson syndrome. Give me a thumbs up. Clinical features are over. Last thing is lab diagnosis. In lab diagnosis, you have to do three things. Number one, blood picture, bone marrow picture, and biochemistry, especially biochemistry. Blood picture, you have to do five things. Hemoglobin ka kya hoga? Of course, it will reduce because iron is less. RBC ka kya hoga? It will reduce. Kyunki hemoglobin kam hai, toh RBC bhi kam banenge. Retic ka kya hoga? Retic count. Retic. What is retic? The precursor of RBC. So it is early normoblast, late intermediate normoblast, late normoblast, then reticulocyte, then RBC. So all of them will reduce. So retic count will also reduce. The indices, MCV, MCH, MCHC, all the three will reduce. WBC will be normal, platelet will be normal. So you have to compare this for not only for this anemia, the various anemias. So lab diagnosis of all 5-6 main anemias you have to compare. You have to compare this lab diagnosis with anemia of chronic disease, with sideroblastic anemia, with thalassemia. So you will know the differences. Being a doctor, you should know. All the patient will come with the same complaint. Doctor, I'm having fatigue and weakness because their hemoglobin is less. All the patient will have less hemoglobin, but rest of the things may differ. So you, based on the rest of the things, apart from hemoglobin, will help you in diagnosing which type of anemia it is. Done. So that is the thing. Bone marrow, cellularity will increase. Now to compensate, cellularity will increase. And which which precursors will increase? It is erythropoiesis, not lymphopoiesis. Myeloid precursors will increase, lymphoid, so any ratio will increase. And marrow iron will also increase. Marrow iron will decrease. So I will come on biochemistry also. Let me teach you this thing. So coming on the blood picture may first hemoglobin. Hemoglobin will fall. As I told you, hemoglobin will be less. Obviously, blood cells, RBCs. Now learn five things. RBCs are hypochromic, microcytic, anisocytosis, poikilocytosis, target cells, ring or pessary cells. I will show you all. Can you see? This is a normal RBC. And can you see? This is a RBC in iron deficiency anemia. So it is smaller. That is microcytic. And see the central pilar. Here central pilar is one third. Here central pilar is more than one third. So that color is less. So it is microcytic hypochromic. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. So compare all here with lymphocyte. Compare all RBCs with lymphocytes. Can you see? All the RBCs are smaller than lymphocyte and pilar is more. Pilar is more. So it is microcytic hypochromic. So it is microcytic hypochromic. It is microcytic hypochromic. Can you see all the RBCs? They are centrally pilar and they are smaller. Microcytic hypochromic. So this is the target cell. At the center, you will see a dot. This is the target cell. So target cells are seen. And can you see one more thing? Some are small, some are large. So an isocytosis is there and shape. Some of them are tear shaped. Some of them are circular. Some of them are spherical. So poikilocytosis is there. So what are the features? It is microcytic, number one. Hypochromic, number two. Anisocytosis, variation in shape, variation in size. Poikilocytosis, variation in shape. And target cells. Target cells. These are the features seen for iron deficiency anemia. You have to learn for image-based questions. If these five features are seen, go for IDA. IDA ka peripheral smear ye hai. So I will take a separate session for IBQs of hematology. All IBQs together. All anemias, all leukemias, only IBQs. The smear. I will show you all smears together in the end. Let me finish hematology first. Coming on retic count, it will be low. Coming on indices, all three indices, MCV, MCH, MCHC will be low, low, low. You should know normal values of them. They will be low. They will be low. Retic count will be low. Leukocytes will be normal. Platelet will be normal. Coming on bone marrow, cellularity will be high. To compensate, cellularity will be high. And ME ratio will decrease. You know, ME ratio, because myeloid, erythroid, mein se kaun badega? Myeloid nahi badega, erythroid badega. So numerator is same, denominator will increase, so ratio will decrease. So ME ratio will decrease. Have you got it? ME ratio will decrease. ME ratio will decrease. That is the thing. And marrow iron stores are decreased. So coming on biochemistry. Let me come on biochemistry. Just a second. Let me come on biochemistry. Marrow iron stores are decreased. Can you see? These are the normal glucolactrucian view for normal marrow, and this is the IDA marrow. You see decrease in blue color. That is Prussian blue is marking the iron. See here normal blue color and here it is absent. Marrow iron stores are decreased. So all these questions be prepared for your IBQs. It is pulsing. Yes, right. Yes, pulsing. It is pulsing for iron. Done. Coming on biochemical findings, that is important. You know in the blood iron is decreased because there is less iron absorption. Now, what about ferritin? Ferritin will also be low in the blood. Iron is low. Ferritin is also low because it's a storage form. What about TIBC and saturation? Tell me two things. Tell me two things. I'm asking you two things. What will happen in IDA? TIBC ka kya hoga IDA mein? TIBC ka kya hoga or transferrin saturation ka kya hoga? Who will tell me in dono ka kya hoga? What do you mean by these things? In dono ka IDA mein kya hoga? Iron deficiency anemia mein whether they will decrease or increase. What will happen to both of them? You should understand the meaning for this. If you understand the meaning, you can answer it. You know this diagram? Who is the car, vehicle of iron? Who is the transporter of iron? You can see the transporter here. This is the transporter of iron. It is known as transferrin. This is known as transferrin. In human blood, in my blood, just suppose 100 transferrin, 100 car are present. Out of them, iron is present only in 33 of them. So normal occupancy is 33%, rest 66% are empty. 60 normal. This is normal. This is normal. Please understand. So 66% are empty. The empty one are known as TIBC. TIBC, the full form of TIBC is transferrin binding capacity. It is more capacity. Hamare paas itni aur capacity hai lane ki. Hamare paas itni aur kya? Hamare paas itni empty hai. So 66% is the capacity. It is TIBC. Aur jitne bhare hue hain, the fulfilled one, 33% is known as transferrin saturation. Transferrin saturation. Now you tell me in IDA what will happen to both of them. खाली वालों का क्या होगा भरे वालों का क्या होगा नॉर्मली आउट ऑफ 100 33% आर सैचुरेटेड एंड 66% cars or transporters or vehicles are empty, the empty one are known as TIBC. Empty one are TIBC. Now iron is less, na? In IDA iron is less. In IDA iron is less. So vehicle तो 100 ही है, car तो आपकी 100 ही रहेंगी ना. अब बैठने वाले कम है, so they will be less than 33%, they will be 20% or 10%. So saturation will decrease और empty वाले बढ़ जाएंगे, they will be 80 or 90%. So TIBC will increase. Have you got it? Have you got it? Have you got it? Yes, yes, you are right. So खाली वाले बढ़ जाएंगे, भरे हुए कम हो जाएंगे. That is the thing. So transfer and saturation decreases and TIBC sees the capacity. That is empty वाले. हमारे पास इतनी और capacity है. What is your capacity? What is your capacity? In capacity, you will tell your empty thing. That is my capacity. So I can fulfill it. And saturation is the fulfilled thing. Have you got it? So TIBC increases and transfer and saturation decreases. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. Everyone, give me a thumbs up. This was the question this year, NEET PG. In few days back now, we are on 12th of September, NEET PG 2021. So this was the question. So that was the basics you should know. Done. Done. So let me tell you one thing. So fill this. Please help me in filling this. Hemoglobin decrease, RBC decrease, retic decrease, all three indices, MCD, MCH, MCHC decrease, WBC normal, platelet normal, cellularity increase, erythropoiesis decrease, and marrow iron decrease, serum iron decrease, serum transferrin decrease, TIBC increase, transferrin saturation decrease. So is pure isme sirf ek cheez badh rahi hai. Is pure isme sirf TIBC is increasing, rest all are decreasing. That was the MCQ this year NEET PG. So only TIBC is increasing. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Fast. Everyone. So there are three differential diagnoses of anemia. All microcytic. SITA. S-I-T-A. All of them are microcytic hyperchromic anemia. So one of them is iron deficiency. What are other three? It is sideroblastic, thalassemia, and anemia of chronic disease. So these are the differential diagnosis. If any patient is coming to you with anemia, if it is microcytic hyperchromic anemia, so you have four differentials and you have to look which among them. So I will teach you all four, then you will understand it properly. Done. Polls launch karne ka to time nahi hai. You can see the polls later on from the notes. You can download the notes. Now, there are many polls which are already asked in the PYQs, but there is no time to launch it, unfortunately. Coming on the treatment. What is the treatment of anemia? Give iron, but treat the cause. What is the cause? If it is blood loss, treat it. If it is peptic ulcer, fix it. If it is hemorrhoids, fix it. What is the cause? Fix the cause. Otherwise, फिर से हो जाएगा. और cause fix करने के बाद give the correction. Give the correction. Iron is less now. Give external iron. External iron can be given in the form of tablets, oral or parenteral in the form of injections. So oral, there are three type of iron tablets. Iron sulfate, ferrous sulfate, ferrous fumarate, ferrous gluconate. Sulfate, fumarate, gluconate. Three types of iron tablets are available in the market for oral therapy. So you can see three types of tablets are there. Most commonly used is iron sulfate. So each tablet, if you know the chemistry mein wo hota na, molecular formula, you add the weight of each of them. So elemental iron kitna hai? Iron fumarate mein elemental iron is 60, it is 33%. Gluconate mein it is 12%. Sulfate mein it is 20%. So maximum elemental iron is in fumarate. So you have to learn it for MCQs. Done. So three types of tablets are available in the market. Have you got it? So iron tablets should not be taken fasting. It should be taken with food. Otherwise, it will cause acidity, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. So it should be taken with the food. Don't take iron tablet with milk. It will form chelates and it will not be absorbed. Done. After taking iron tablet, patient will feel better because hemoglobin synthesis will start. The first thing you will see, the correction is reticulocytosis. In the blood, retic count will increase. So that means iron tablet is working. That is oral therapy. To whom patient we give injections? Usually we give oral therapy only. Parenteral iron, that is in the form of injectable form. Parenteral is given to in rare condition. If patient cannot tolerate oral therapy, patient is having diarrhea, patient is having vomiting on taking the tablet, it is irritative tablet, huh? Then we give parenteral. If the patient is having require rapid replenishment, means patient is pregnant and next week delivery is planned and patient is severe anemic. At the time of delivery, blood loss will be there now. So we have only 1 week. We cannot give tablets. We will give parenteral. And post-op in GIT disorders like malabsorption, so we give parenteral therapy. These are the reasons for parenteral. Parenteral is expensive and it is hazardous. Side effects are more. So we avoid parenteral usually. But response is faster. In parenteral, response is faster. In parenteral, we have only one preparation, iron dextran. Oral ke liye teen the. Sulfate, fumarate, glyconate. These are the ferrous sulfate, ferrous fumarate. Parenteral ke liye sirf ek preparation hai, iron dextran. iron dextran. There are no three preparations, only one preparation. How much iron dextran you will give? How much you will give? How much? If you give 250 milligram of iron, it will increase hemoglobin by 1 gram. So just suppose my hemoglobin is 7 gram. I want to make it 12 gram. Minimum 12 gram should be there, na? So from 7 to 12, I need to increase by 5 units. So 5 into 250. If I give 250, it will increase by 1 unit. Another 250, another 1 unit. Another 250, so 250 into 5. Whatever it is, 1250 grams I have to give. So depending what is your hemoglobin deficit, it is known as deficit. Hai itna, chahiye itna. So deficit kitna hai? 5 ka. So 5 into 250. So itna de doge, itna to doge. Okay, what this you have given, so you have replenished the iron in the blood. What about storage? There is still no storage. Storage is zero. For storage, give additional 500. So 1250 ke upar plus 500, I will give 1750 to the patient. Give me a thumbs up or 1750 ka main ye laga dungi. It is 1750. Depending if the hemoglobin is 7, I will give 1750. Hemoglobin agar 3 hai to kitna dungi? Hemoglobin 3 hai. Chahiye kitna? 12. To kitna deficit hai? 9. So 9 into 250, jo bhi answer aega, plus 500. That I will inject. Give me a thumbs up. That is iron dextran. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So that is the thing. So this is the formula and response of therapy is seen by reticulocytosis. So thank you very much. I have to stop here. Just give me 1 minute. Polls I was unable to launch. There are many good questions given in my notes. Please. And notes are complete. It contains all anemias. Next lecture ki bhi notes isi mein hai, uske next ki bhi isi mein hai. So notes are in this PDF only. I will install the same PDF every time. So please take the notes, download the notes, go on the app after the lecture, download the notes. Thank you for being with me. I will continue the lecture tomorrow. Thank you. My next class tomorrow morning, today evening, I'm having class, but for plus subscribers, respiratory system pathology today evening, 4:30 onwards. Done. Tomorrow, free class. I'm having 3 free classes tomorrow. So 9 a.m. in the morning, first class 9 to 10. Second class 10:15 to 11:15. 15 minute break hoga beech mein. 10:15 to 11:15. The third class 11:30 to 12:30. So first class I teach you micro. Second class I will teach you pharma. The third class I will teach you patho. Done. Tomorrow. So in micro I will teach you all DNA viruses tomorrow. Don't dare to miss it. There are 6 DNA viruses: herpes, hepatina, pox virus, parvovirus, picornavirus, and adenovirus. So these 6 viruses I'm going to teach you tomorrow, a comparative table between them. Don't dare to miss morning 9 a.m. live lecture. After that, in pharmacology, I will teach you DOTS tomorrow, anti-tubercular drugs, DOTS, and MDR and XDR, multi-drug resistant TB, extensive drug resistant treatment. So don't dare, it is a super important topic. Don't dare to miss it. And in patho, we will continue anemias tomorrow. So rest of the anemia, that is sideroblastic anemia, anemia of chronic disease, aplastic anemia, PARCA, these are small, huh? So, choti, 5, 10 minutes mein each anemia. And after that, I will start with the hemolytic anemia, all hemolytic anemias together. So, one lecture on anemia. So, don't dare to miss it tomorrow morning, 3 lectures back to back. So, you join me 9 a.m. in the morning tomorrow till 12:30 p.m. tomorrow morning. I want all of you. All the 3 classes will be on special class only, and all of them will be free for all students. If any newcomer is joining, he will require a code. The code is Sachdev 10, you know it. Don't forget to give your feedbacks to me. And you know my code is Sachdev 10. Please help me in distributing this code to unlock the free classes to the newcomers, new students on your batch group, seniors, juniors. On plus subscription, on paid subscription, we have 2 subscriptions, plus and iconic. In plus, you get access to an academy live and recorded lectures. In iconic, along with an academy, you will get prep letter also. So if you're thinking of taking a plus subscription, go with iconic. And you know, we have a highly effective question bank available on the plus platform containing more than 25,000 clinical image based questions for your practice. So if you take the subscription, you will get benefit of this also. We are really proud of our stand on us. I want your next photograph here. So please be ready to give your next photograph to me so that I can show you to your juniors next year. Done. So be prepared for it. Just take the advantage, extra age of plus subscription, and just modify, just benefit from it and get your rank. These are the batches available on the plus platform. One for next, one for FMG, one for INICT, one for clinical examination procedure. If you take the paid subscription, you will get access to all these batches. Last 2 offers for you. If you take a subscription for 24 months, you will get 4 months extra. If you take a subscription for 12 months, you will get 2 months extra. Done. And these are the prices of various subscriptions in Plus and in Iconic. Can you see? So in Plus, it is starting from 1 month, as small as 1 month, and as large as 4 years. Longer the subscription, cheaper it is. Whatever subscription you are planning to take, apply code Sachdev 10. You will get 10% discount. So the summary is that the code is useful for all students. Those students who want to watch the classes free, for them also the code is useful for unlocking the free class. So please distribute it to all your batch groups, seniors, juniors, everyone. And those who want to take the paid subscription, applying the code, they will get heavy discount. They will get 10% discount on the payment on whatever subscription. So please learn the code as such. They can see you tomorrow morning for free class. And for Plus subscribers, classes today evening at 4:30 sharp. Plus subscribers, don't miss it. Okay, see you. Bye-bye. Study hard, children. I'm ending this lecture.